Have you ever wondered what it takes to get a 9 in GCSE biology? If so, then you're in the right video today because I'm going to be sharing with you all 10 tips on how to get a 9 in GCSE biology very much easily that you can be starting implementing from today onwards and applying them into your revision sessions. So if you're interested to find out the top 10 tips, then please keep watching this video till the end. So these 10 tips have been gathered in based on these three areas. First one is based on my own personal experience and mistakes that I have made when I was making or when I was undertaking my GCSE biology exam. Number two is based on my sister's school's teacher's advice on how to get a 9. And of course, number three is based on research and watching as many YouTube videos as possible on this topic. So these three areas have been combined together to make this whole entire video on these 10 advanced tips and in general, how to get a 9 in biology. So if you're interested, then please keep watching it too. Before I begin with the advanced tips on how to get a 9 in biology or GCSE biology, I would like to first start off with the four basic tips which I've already mentioned in my previous GCSE videos. Number one is making sure that you're looking at the mark scheme, teachers' comments, as well as the examiner reports as much as possible so that you get familiarized on what it takes to get a 9, as well as what are the teachers are looking for in terms of what kind of points you should be making answering questions in the exam. Number two is making sure that you're practicing as many past papers as possible, which is quite self-explanatory. Now that it is exam season, it is very important for you to get in touch with as many past papers as possible. Number three is making sure that you're watching as many YouTube videos or any other online free resources that are available for you to revise for biology and GCSE biology in general and learn as many things as possible. And of course, number four is sending as much as work as possible to the teachers, and this can be through email if you can't meet them up, and if you can meet them up, then of course in school, then you meet them up during lunchtime or after school. In that way, you will get an understanding of the topic that you may not be understanding really much so, and also it will show in a way that you're working really hard for your subject, for biology, GCSE biology anyway. So that can be, and these four tips are very, very important for you to implement right now. So now I'm going to be moving on to the advanced tips, and the first one is to use as many active recall strategies as much as possible in your revision and your revision session in general. So the first one, it can be, for example, spaced repetition to make sure that you're reviewing the content as many times as possible before you actually end up forgetting them. Number two is, of course, for example, flashcards. In a way, that can be a really good way to summarize the content that you might be learning in terms of biology and all the topics and chapters and subtopics, making sure that you're not missing out any of them, especially if the teachers have already told you what topics are coming up in the exam. So you want to use as many active recall strategies to make sure they're reviewing the content before you forget, and as well as you want to have a cheat sheet almost to make sure that you're summarizing the content in a manner that you can remember it instantly. Number two advanced tip is making sure that you know all the command words and what they actually mean in terms of how to structure your answers in the exam and any kind of exam question that might be coming up. So you want to make sure that you know what does explain mean, discuss mean, compare and contrast, and all these kind of command words that are really, really important for you to understand, because if you don't know what they're telling you to or how to answer the question, then you might answer in a different way that the examiner may not be looking for. In that way, you're going to be losing marks. So search up on Google maybe or something like that on how to, what are command words and what they actually mean and how to structure your answers accordingly, so that in that way you know exactly what to write and how much you have to write as well based on the number of marks that have been provided in the question. So you want to make sure that you are researching as many command words as possible and practicing them as many times as possible. So number three advanced tip is making sure that you are highlighting the most difficult topics and working on them from now onwards, because you want to make sure that you're giving as much as time as possible for you to really understand the difficult subjects, because first of all, they might take time for you to really understand them, and second of all, you might get these wrong very easily in the exam if they come up as a question. So you want to make sure that you are using other different strategies to make sure that you are teaching this material to others. For example, maybe using the Feynman technique, which has been very popular in terms of drawing it and explaining it and teaching it to yourself. So it can be a really good way for you to really understand these difficult subjects, because you never know whichever topic is going to be coming, and even if you have been given a list of all the topics, it does not mean that you know all of them. So you want to make sure that you're giving allocated time or time limits or the amount of days you're going to be focusing on those topics and making sure that you are acing them as much as possible. Number four advanced tip is making sure that you're not forgetting any lab experiments, the practical stages and the practical skills in general, because those questions can also come up as a 10 marker or 12 marker, I believe, in the exam. So if you forget any kind of stages on when, how you conducted the experiment or the lab experiment, that can be really difficult for you to really achieve the highest number of marks. So you want to make sure that you're keeping a good set of organized notes on how you have conducted each and every type of lab experiments during your school time. And in that way, you would be able to know exactly what you're writing, and also you'll not be losing marks. So you want to make sure that you are not forgetting any lab experiments, the practical skills that you have learned, and also the each and every single stages as to which you have conducted that experiment. Tip number five is making sure that you're recording your own notes and listening to them whenever you get tired of doing past papers, or whenever you are really bored and tired of reading your textbook, or any of those kind of things. You want to make sure that you're recording and listening to your own notes, so that in that way you're not at least procrastinating or doing something else instead of studying. So you want to make sure that you have different kinds of strategies, as I mentioned before, on how to revise and study for your GCSE biology, because the more creative you are at this stage, the better it will be, because you're less likely to get bored or less likely to procrastinate in general. So you want to make sure that this will be my best tip, I would say, especially if you're somebody who gets really bored easily when studying, is to record your own notes and listening to them when you're commuting, maybe, or whenever you're walking around the house, or when you're having a walk outside the park or something like that. In that way, it can boost your memory and you will remember the topics better. Tip number six is making sure that you are reading around the subject and know your definitions inside out. And to find the definitions, of course, you can look at the exam boards that you have been provided. So that if it's AQA for you, then look at the AQA exam board and see what definitions they want you to learn inside out. And in terms of reading around the subject, I would highly recommend for you to read maybe science magazines or the news, or watching the news, of course, and also reading around the articles or anything like that they might be provided online or in school as well. So in that way you are aware of the subject. But of course, this is more like an A-level tip, I would say, which is to read around the subject. But it doesn't really hurt if you yourself also read around, even if you're a GCSE student, because if there's a question that you found very surprising in the exam and you write something about it, that will definitely make you stand out. And even if you don't get marks for it, it will just give an impression that you have read around the subject before. So I would highly recommend for you to read around the subject and also know your definitions inside out. This brings you to the end of today's video. I hope you really enjoyed this video and found that the tips really, really helpful, for basic tips and six advanced tips. And if you have found this video really helpful, then of course share this video with other friends that you might have who also might be undertaking their GCSEs this year or next year. In that way, they're well prepared for it and how to get a 9, because I'm sure all of you are capable of getting a 9, very much so. And other than that, if you're interested in kind of law school, productivity, self-growth kind of videos, as well as GCSE and A-level kind of videos, then please do subscribe to this channel, because this channel is very much perfect for you. But other than that, I will see you in my next week's video.